Hi everyone, today we will do legal dictation exercise number 52. You can also get the PDF link from the description box. So ready? Start. There is another aspect of the matter which disentitles the appellant from seeking the relief of divorce on the ground of desertion in this case. As desertion in matrimonial case means the withdrawal of one party from a state of thing that is a marital status of the party, no party to the marriage can be permitted to allege desertion unless he or she admits that after the formal ceremonies of the marriage, the parties had recognized and discharged the common obligation of the married life, which essentially required the cohabitation between the parties for the purpose of consummating the marriage. Cohabitation by the parties is an essential of a valid marriage, as the object of the married is to further the perpetuation of the race by permitting lawful indulgence in passion for procreation of children. In other words, there can be no desertion without previous cohabitation by the parties. The basis for this theory is built upon the recognized position of law in matrimonial matters that no one can desert who does not actively or willfully bring to an end the existing state of cohabitation. However, such a rule is subject to just exception, which may be found in a case on the ground of mental or physical incapacity or other peculiar circumstance of the case. However, the party seeking divorce on the ground of desertion required to show that he or she was not taking the advantage of his or her own wrong. In the instant case, the appellant herself pleaded that there had been cohabitation between the parties after the marriage. She neither assigned any reason nor attributed the non-assumption of the cohabitation to the respondent. From the pleading and evidence led in the case, it is apparent that the appellant did not permit the respondent to have cohabitation for consummating the marriage. In the absence of cohabitation between the parties, a particular state of matrimonial position was never permitted by the appellant to come into existence. In the present case, the absence of cohabitation and consummation of the marriage, the appellant was disentitled to claim divorce on the ground of desertion. No evidence was led by the appellant to show that she was forced to leave the company of the respondent or that she was thrown away from the matrimonial home or that she was forced to live separately and that the respondent had intended animus disrendi. There is nothing on record to hold that the respondent had ever declared to bring the marriage to an end or refuses to have cohabitation with the appellant. As a matter of fact, the appellant is proved to have abandoned the matrimonial home and declined to cohabit with the respondent and thus forbearing to perform the matrimonial obligation. In any proceeding under the Act, whether defendant or not, the court would decline to grant relief to the petitioner if it is found that the petitioner was taking advantage of his or her own wrong or disability for the purpose of the relief contemplated under Section 23(1) of the Act. Thank you.